Hello, class. How is everyone doing today?
I'm not gonna lie to you, Mr. Price. I'm a little bit nervous about this test tomorrow. I'm not very confident in my studies.
Well, that's perfect then, because today we are learning about the urinary system.
Oh no, not another PowerPoint!
Nope, no PowerPoint today. We are going on a special journey.
To where?
The urinary system. Three lucky winners will take a trip inside of me and explore my urinary system by traveling through my kidney and my renal tubule. Which three of you kids want to be lucky enough to enter the urinary system itself?
Me! I want to go!
Before you volunteer, just know that there is a catch. After you thoroughly explore my urinary system, I will ask you a series of questions. If you cannot answer the questions correctly, you are not prepared for the test tomorrow, and therefore you will be stuck inside of me forever. Hope you don't choke-y-mokey.
Me, I wanna go!
No,
me,
I wanna go!
Me,
no,
I wanna
me.
Go!
No,
I wanna
me.
Go.
Pick me,
I'm raising my hand.
I wanna go.
Okay, so not Anna, and not Sean or Rachel either, and definitely not Mari or Hannah. How about Leah, Mary Kate, and I guess Maddie?
Yes.
Okay, girls, prepare for the journey of a lifetime.
We're ready!
Here we go. See you on the other side.
Whoa, where are we? This is weird.
Yeah, I'm really not a fan.
Let's study before Price tests us at the end.
Yeah, I don't want to be stuck in his body forever.
Okay, let's review what we know. We know that the urinary system contains the kidneys, the ureters, the bladder, and the urethra.
We also know that the excretory system is responsible for the maintenance of the right levels of water and dissolved substances in the body.
Right, isn't that called osmoregulation? It's when the body gets rid of all the stuff it doesn't need by maintenance of a constant osmotic pressure through salt and water concentration.
I think that's a pretty solid base. Let's get started.
Whoa, is that lemonade? Let's follow it down.
Where are we?
We are now in the kidneys. The kidneys are the start of the urinary system, and they are in charge of maintaining water levels and dissolved materials, and also in charge of controlling blood pressure in the body.
Fun fact, did you know that the kidneys filter out 180 liters of fluid from the blood, but you only pee out 1.5 liters of it?
Why do you know that?
Well, I had a urinary infection when I was younger, and my mom made me learn all about it. I also know that the kidneys filter lots of fluid from the blood. They reabsorb the 99% of it back into the body before sending the last 1% of it out in the form of urine.
How does that even work?
All this happens using nephrons. Each kidney has millions of them, and if you were to lay them out in a straight line, they would reach over 80 kilometers. I guess I just know things.
All right, whatever. What else do we need to know?
We know that blood from the heart enters the kidneys through renal arteries. As the blood enters, it is forced through a system of tiny capillaries until it enters the glomerulus, which is another system of tiny capillaries located inside the cup-shaped Bowman's capsule. Each Bowman's capsule is located at the end of a nephron.
This system is called filtration. About one-fifth of the fluid portion of the blood filters into the Bowman's capsule, and the rest of the fluid remains in capillaries.
I know this. The pressure from the glomerulus is super high and it squeezes some fluid out of the blood. What is being squeezed out is no longer considered blood. It is now called filtrate.
That was too much squeezing for me. I feel very compressed.
Let's keep going!
Where did that dump us out?
Now we enter the proximal convoluted tubule. While in here, we will travel to the loop of Henle.
Ooh, I love learning about the loop of Henle. I can't wait to see it in real life. I know everything about the loop. The loop of Henle does three important things. One, it extracts most water we need from the filtrate as it travels down to the medulla, which is the innermost part of the kidney. Two, it pumps out salts that we want to keep on the way back up to the cortex, which is the outermost layer of the kidney. It is, and also, where the glomerulus, a Bowman's capsule, and the convoluted tubules are. And third, it makes the medulla hypertonic to filtrate. This creates a concentration gradient that lets the medulla draw out even more water. The loop of Henle was discovered by Frederick Gustav Jacob Henle.
Geez, is there anything else we need to know?
Yes, actually. The filtrate moves down the loop, and because the membrane is highly permeable to water, the filtrate loses more and more water as it moves down the loop. By the time it gets to the bottom of the loop, it is highly concentrated. Then the filtrate begins to enter the ascending part of the loop. Here, the membrane is not permeable to the water and is lined with channels that transport sodium, potassium, and chlorine. As the filtrate ascends, lots of salt flows out of it. This whole process ensures that the sodium chloride concentration stays high.
Wow, that's a lot. Now that we finally exited the loop of Henley, where are we?
We have now entered the distal convoluted tubule. This tubule regulates levels of potassium, sodium, and calcium.
We are almost ready to be expelled. Now that we have gone through the renal tubule, which was the loop of Henle, and both convoluted tubules, the filtrate is mainly just excess water, urea, which is the most common metabolic waste, along with other metabolic wastes.
So close, yet so far. Now, urine from several renal tubules has to flow into a collecting duct. The urine is even further concentrated in the collecting duct by the osmosis of water through the duct wall. This is to help conserve water.
Urine from the collecting duct flows through the renal pelvis, which is a funnel-shaped structure in the center of the kidney. It flows through the pelvis and into a narrow tube called the ureter.
The ureter flows from each kidney to the urinary bladder. This is a muscular sac that stores the urine. Muscular contractions of the bladder force urine out of the body through the urethra.
At least 500 milliliters of urine must be eliminated every day in order to remain healthy. Urinating this much removes potentially toxic materials from the body and allows the body to maintain homeostasis.
A normal and healthy adult eliminates 1.5 liters to 2.3 liters of urine a day, depending on the amount of water taken in and also on the amount of water lost through respiration and perspiration.
Well, girls, it looks like we officially reached the end.
How is Mr. Price going to ask us questions if we're inside of him?
Hello, girls! How was your journey?
It was fine, but I just want to get out of here. Ask us those questions.
Okay, my only question for you girls is, do you understand the urinary system more than you did before?
Oh, that's all you're asking?
Yup.
This experience was very interesting, and it helped us understand the topic in more depth.
Actually, walking through the urinary system was much more helpful than reading a textbook.
I feel much more prepared for our test tomorrow.
Great! Come on back, girls! Girls.
Leah, you need to wake up. You fell asleep when Mr. Price was reviewing.
Perjury.
Is Leah sleeping? Oh, she can't afford to be sleeping. She needs to pay attention. Grading her test is going to be a slaughter fest. Leah, you need to wake up. You need to pay attention to my review.
What? Hey, I guess it was all just a dream, but at least I know my urinary system.